today I'm gonna teach you another Japanese fashion feature. Whoop! Wait a second, not at all. Actually, today I am wearing German fashion and I'm going to compare it a little bit with Lolita fashion and tell you some things that might be similar, some things that might be completely different. So let's check out German traditional fashion. So number one is, let's just start with the head because that's easier. So head, jajang. You can see I braided my hair into two braids and very simply just went and put it on the top and stitched it up with just some normal pins. So that is super easy to do. It looks really complicated and everyone thinks I spend a lot of time on this, but actually I just made two pigtails, braided them, put them up, stitched them together. Very easy. To give it an extra accent, I added a little flower here in the same color as my German dress, which is also called Dirndl. I'm gonna talk about that one in a moment. Also, because this style uses purple a lot, I added a little bit of purple eyeshadow. It's come off a little bit because I already spent most of the day in this, but that's the kind of style I went for. Again, tried to be start quite simple, but I couldn't resist and used a little bit of Japanese style, put a little bit of highlighter in the middle here. That's about it. And rosy cheeks, which works a lot well with this dress. Also, to match this whole thing up, I'm wearing a little heart necklace, which is made out of glass. Another thing that really helps is maybe have pretzels or Edelweiss flowers as accessories, which is often used when you wear these kind of dresses. So let's focus on the actual dress that I have here. So this is called Dirndl, which is a German traditional dress that you wear, for example, in Bavaria or sometimes also in parts of Austria and other parts where you speak German, which is interesting. So there is nothing particular to the color because we have by now so many different colors of traditional dresses. There's a great variety, but this is the main part of it. So let's first actually start up here with the blouse. It has puffy little sleeves, which is cute, which has a similarity to Lolita fashion. Sometimes you have nice and puffy sleeves on some Lolita fashion styles. However, the thing that you might have noticed, especially if you're a guy, is that compared to Lolita fashion, there's one part that is definitely different, and it's you showing quite a lot of breasts. Don't come so close! That's actually part of this Dirndl style. You're supposed to push your boobs up a little bit and create a kind of heart. This area is called Herza, which is called a kind of a heart. You see this come up here, and if you have even more boobies, it will come up in a round way, so it's called Herza heart, which obviously this area is very important if you wear a traditional dirndl. You'll see lots of girls walking around like this in the Oktoberfest season, for example, or at German festivals, interestingly enough. Now, sometimes the style tips recently, and older people or some people who don't want to show too much, they actually have closed up blouses. This is the blouse I got recommended with this dress when I went and bought it this year. Now, focusing on the dirndl, you have cross pattern in front of here, and this one actually has a reason. It helps you to adjust the dirndl just to your size, because on the back of it, there is no shearing. To check this out, there's absolutely no shearing, and it has to come up this high so it pushes up your chest in a nice way. So, and also there's a reason why the bow is not at the back, which it would be in Lolita fashion. It's on the side, because depending on where the bow is, it has a different meaning. My friend taught me this when we went to Oktoberfest. I'll put that in the top right of the screen once that video is done. Left hand side means you're single, right hand signs mean you're taken, in the middle means you're a virgin, which is more for kids. On the back, it means that you are either widowed or that you are serving like a waitress. So that's the different ways where you wear the bow. So that's actually quite important when you have the apron. So let's focus a little bit on the dress again. We have some stitching here on the flowers and down here. So that one is actually one of the reasons why I picked this dress. I wanted to wear purple and I wanted to have like a cute pattern on this, so you can see. It's all stitched on here, which again showed that this one is a good quality dirndl. They're quite a lot of cheap, they call them China dirndls, recently on the market. And I wanted to have one that has a bit of quality on it. Also, coming back to the apron, there's a little bit of glitter here. As you can see, a little bit of glitter here, which has been popular recently to kind of make the dirndl look a little bit more flashy. Also, if you come up here to the hooks, again, sparkles here. Right here in the hooks that hold the extra adjustment for the dirndl. If you're curious, you can see down here there's actually a way to open this and make this even wider or make it even smaller in case I lose or gain some weight. This is actually, it sits quite tight. You can compare this a little bit to a corset, It's a little bit like a corset the way it's cut, so it pushes everything up a little bit and makes you look nice and skinny. So I'm surprised, like, my waist size has gone down 2 sizes now since I lived in Japan. I used to be a 36, this is a 32 size dirndl now, which you need to wear them just your size, so it works and it fits properly. Which I was surprised about too, I thought I could just wear it like that. So that's another thing. Mentioning that, if you take off the apron, it just goes up simply like this. And what's similar with later fashion is, this skirt is quite long. It goes up straight to your knee size. And recently what has also been popular is some people wear a petticoat underneath their dirndl. Some people do that to poof it up a little bit and give it a kind of cupcake shape, similar to Lolita fashion, which is interesting. So, comparison and shoes. Actually, by the way, are some simple leather shoes. Obviously, you can wear some more traditional shoes with this, but I wear a black dress and I wanted to have some simple shoes that are still kind of warm because it's getting cold now these days. So, let's compare it to things in later fashion. So, things that are similar and things that are definitely not similar. So let's come back up. Okay, blouse is a must. I haven't seen anyone without a blouse, so that's similar to Lolita fashion. However, no cleavage in Lolita fashion, and if possible in Lolita fashion, you wear long sleeves as well. Don't show too much skin. Then corset-wise, you sometimes see people wear corsets with Lolita fashion, it's a plus and minus, so that's not quite as similar, but sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, depending on your style. Haven't seen many sweet Lolitas with corsets, but sometimes it still happens. Also, aprons. Sometimes you have aprons on Lolita dresses, and sometimes you don't have aprons. Some people hate aprons with Lolita dresses, depending on what type of Lolita you are. Well, obviously the way you tie your bow is not important in the same way, so this one has a certain meaning to it, where Lolitas usually wear on the back and sometimes have an extra one on the front. Length of the skirt-wise, it's the same. And you can wear it with a petticoat, which would again be similar, but this one you can wear without a petticoat. And then again, no over knees in this one. And well, if you wear Lolita fashion, a nice tight pair of tights or over knees can be realized with Lolita fashion, but in this case, you show a bit more skin. Again, these ones, these dresses are there to appeal, be nice and youthful. Some people wear dirndl. They wear them for work, they wear them for weddings, and not only festivals. So this is a kind of traditional German dress that you might be able to see. Not so much in some parts of Germany, all the traditions have been pushed aside, but in the south of Germany, where there's Munich, many people are still sticking with their traditions, and I must say, I've met quite a lot of people who still work in this, like grown-up ladies usually, or obviously waitresses. But grown-up ladies, for example, in the city hall, in my town, they wear this. They wear these kind of clothes. It's quite exciting, to be honest. Every time I see it, I can't believe it. Anyways, that was my Friday fashion feature today. If you're curious about more fashion features, I'll put them on the top right of the screen. And if you don't want to know how does this actually work when you go to the Oktoberfest and celebrate, I will make a video about this. This will come up this weekend. And I put that also in the top right on the screen once it's up. So by the time you see this, it might already be released, depending on when you watch this. So hopefully you can follow me along to the Oktoberfest and have some beer with me and learn a little bit about German traditional fashion. So thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for watching this all the way to the end. I appreciate that, appreciate that, appreciate that lots and lots and lots. And as you can see, I've been speaking so much German that my English is getting a little bit wibbly wobbly since I just came back. But you will find out what I did in Germany. The videos are coming up this weekend. So thank you very much for watching and catch you soon on my channel. Thank you, bye. Super. Okay, funny face. 3, 2, 1.